is one of the old traditions followed by the Indians to lead a life that induces relaxation and provides health benefits to the one following it. It reflects its purpose to a method of controlling the mind by uniting the individual dominant energy with the universal. Yoga is not just an exercise. It is a process and system through which the human beings can achieve their highest possible potential. Cognitive enhancers has been of significant interest in the recent years. Yoga is associated with reduced stress and increased well-being, even though the molecular basis of these benefits is not clear. The modern world is facing a pandemic of lifestyle disorders, which requires changes to be made consciously by the individuals themselves. The entire world is now caught in a vise-like grip of the COVID-19 pandemic, with 200 countries reporting casualties increasing alarmingly moment by moment. During the quarantine, our thoughts and emotions can affect our immune system. Stress, fear, and negative thoughts can affect our immune system, while yoga, including mindfulness, meditation, relaxation, can strengthen it. As a part of the Bright 2020 project, our study focuses on the physical and the cognitive benefits associated with yoga and mindfulness using surface-based EEG technique.
For this study, we have selected two sitting posture and one stretching posture, among which Vajrasana and Swastikasana are the sitting posture and Surya Namaskara is the stretching posture.
Vajrasana. It resembles a meditative posture. Body becomes upright and straight with no effort while performing this asana. Vajrasana can alter the blood flow and nerve impulses in the pelvic region, and it also strengthens the pelvic region. Swastikasana. It is a calm sitting pose with an upright upper body and stretching the legs forward and bending them to the thighs. It helps in the relaxation of mind, stretches the lower body, and optimizes organ functioning. Surya Namaskar. Surya Namaskar consists of 12 powerful yoga poses. A study based on the difference between Surya Namaskar training when performed in a slow and fast manner reported that the effects of fast Surya Namaskar are similar to physical aerobic exercises, whereas the effects of slow Surya Namaskar are similar to those of yoga training. It is also known to have a positive impact on the mind and body. It helps in enhancing cognitive functions, improves health, stimulates the nervous system, and maintains cardiovascular health.
Our study focuses on the variations and cortical reorganizations in intersubjects for static and dynamic male and female yoga practitioners. For that, we selected 70 healthy volunteering subjects of mean age 21 years. We have divided the subjects into three groups. Experimental group 1 consists of female subjects, experimental group 2 consists of male subjects, and a control group which consists of both male and female subjects.
Experimental group 1 and 2 have practiced both sitting postures, that is Vajrasana and Swastikasana, and stretching posture, that is Surya Namaskara, for the duration of 6 weeks. The control is not needed to practice these yoga techniques during the course of study. In this study, we have incorporated the 14 electrode emotive epoch device, which is easy to use in a laboratory setting. The length of each trial is 2 minutes and 40 seconds. A computational analysis software, MATLAB, was used for the further extraction of the EEG signals, as its signal processing functions can be utilized to make these signals more readable and easier to be analyzed. As a reference for analyzing the effects of yoga in daily life activities, 3 cognitive tasks, namely digit letter substitution task, word memory task, and goal in incomplete figure task, was accustomed to the participants.
We hypothesize that compared to the seated contemplative practices, the added movement component of yoga-based practice may increase the intensity of introspective and proprioceptive signals and subsequently facilitate the processing and integration. Hence, yoga-based practices may offer a potentially even more effective method for cultivating bodily awareness as well as general attentional skills.
During the period of study, the EEG recording of 3 groups were taken and compared. When comparing between static and dynamic group,
from the plots, it was observed that there was a decrease in beta rhythms in the left anterior and frontal region when compared to pre-yoga recording. A decrease in alpha rhythm was also observed in the right temporal motor cortex and frontal region, which reflects a gradual increase in attention. In case of dynamic group, it was observed that there was a beta activation in the temporal and parietal region. The right motor cortex region was also found to be activated after the dynamic yoga. Gender-based comparison showed a decrease in beta rhythms in the left anterior and frontal region when compared to pre-yoga recording. In female subject, there was a significant activation in the right frontal lobe, whereas in male subject, an alpha activation was observed in the frontal region. Mental map comparison shows that there was a profound alpha activation in the parietal and occipital region in the yoga subject. A t-test was computed to compare the mean of both experimental group 1 and group 2 subject. The scores for both digit letter substitution task and word memory task among the subject were compared for significance difference. The signal factor ANOVA show a significance difference between the subject. This correlates to a significantly higher attention skill and memory among the yoga group when compared to the control group.
This study mainly focuses on understanding the neural correlates of cognitive tasks such as attention, working memory and visual perception by analyzing the effect of yoga on daily life activities with brain mapping activity using EEG and percentage power spectral density analysis. Cortical mapping of alpha rhythm in both the yoga practitioners shows an increase in parietal and occipital region, suggesting that yoga-based practices increases attention and stimulus-response associations. Also, an increase in alpha rhythm in the frontal region suggests regulatory functions related to emotional challenges and attentional engagements. An increase in alpha and beta activity in the posterior parietal lobe suggests an increase in working memory. Also, a decrease in beta activity in the left frontal lobe suggests an increase in working memory.
Studies showed that asana-based yoga postures improved alpha wave activation in the brain. Yoga training may be associated with increased beta activity and reduction of parameters such as emotional exhaustion, state anxiety and fatigue. Evidence shows that alpha and theta waves increase primarily in the parietal region after a yoga intervention. This meant that the brain was more deeply relaxed after yoga and there was reduction in feelings of anxiousness and having better control of his or her emotional state. Memory and emotional regulation is controlled mainly by the frontal lobe and amygdala. Several studies were conducted to examine the effect of yoga practice on the frontal lobe and amygdala. A study reported that activation of the right amygdala has resulted in decreased blood flow as reported through a PET scan. These results also reported increased cerebral blood flow to the frontal lobes as areas within the frontal lobes are involved in prolonged focus and attention. Yoga is a great gift to mankind which helps us keep better and maintain our life. You also develop a higher patience level when you practice yoga, which also helps in keeping the negative thoughts away. You get great mental clarity and better understanding. In short, yoga has several benefits. It is the secret to living a healthy and long life without the use of any artificial means like medicines or any other shortcuts of any kind. Anyone can practice yoga, no matter what your age is or whichever religion you follow.
We, the students of Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham, conducted this study as a part of our Bright 2020 project at the Computational Neuroscience Lab of School of Biotechnology. These are our preliminary results and needs to be validated with more number of subjects and trials.